morning, my colleagues on the dais, the great audience. We came here despite our rains, so we got slightly delayed. Nothing uncommon in Delhi. Fine. This topic, M2M forum, when these people approached me, so I said, M2M, what is this? So it was a news for me that there is something called M2M. Because in reality, I really did not know what is M2M. You heard about it. But then I was just thinking that what is M2M? And how suddenly it has become important. I found that there was a third global conference, happened sometime back, sometime in September 13. They are also having a third conference on M2M in India. So, anyway, from the industry I come, this was something like, which was a bit, because it happens to be our area, so I was slightly getting inquisitive, like, what is suddenly M2M has become important? Anyway, the way the Mr. Vimal shared a lot, so I also have historical background, because I really don't know what is M2M still. I am confused. So if you understand after this seminar, I'll request organizers to please let me know. When we were in the beginning of the journey, in the telecommunication started, the machine to machine started because there was a communication in between. Machine itself is a machine, it does everything itself. Like, so the Morse code was the first thing. I could send a code from here and somewhere it receives. Now, in my little understanding of the subject, I thought this is a machine to machine communication. This machine is communicating to that machine, because normal communication we understand what we communicate. Then we found that, okay, now it is becoming a problem because somebody is pressing a key. Many of you might not have even seen this instrument. I have privilege of seeing it because in Indian Railways we have been using it for quite recently, till about maybe 15 years back when I was in the field. The instrument we are maintaining. The station master used to send the code and somebody at the other end will listen and decode that. Then probably the teleprinter came. He said it is becoming difficult that somebody has to be physically present. So let somebody type and somebody comes in. Now, when these things are known for over almost 100 years, why suddenly this M2M have become very important? Okay, then my thought process went ahead. I thought, okay, now TV remote at home. I press a remote and the TV starts. Earlier TVs did not have remote. Many of you might have seen it. Youngsters might not have even seen those TVs. You had to physically go and there was a knob selector or there was a physical selector. But the remote came, now the remote is communicating with the computer, with the TV. Switch on, off, basic command, channel up, down. So, I got more confused. Fine, if the TV remote was a machine-to-machine communication, then what are we talking? Then we got computer. First, the computer was standalone. There was a big computer, giant rooms. I have seen, I have worked on those computers, IBM 1401 series, where every card, and I have seen a transformer and resistance making a computer, which you people cannot even imagine now, the youngsters particularly. And I was in the hardware side, so we used to take out those cards and repair them. Whatever, like ultimately it is a technology. Now those things now get in the form of chips. So when the computers came, they used to be standalone, they could not communicate, but in those computers also, like the input processor and the terminal, the output, the printer or whatever the device, they used to communicate. Then we grew further, we found that something of network is happening. This computer can talk to some computer in remote location. This computer can talk to some other computer in remote location. Then the communication became simpler, rather more technology became advanced. We could find that we can talk to any computer. Earlier, there used to be a master computer and there were clients around it. So you could work, we used to call it, if I correctly recall that, multiple ports, like multiple terminals could work. Earlier, only one terminal could input, other terminal could output. Card punching machines type concept. Now, this became many people can work on the computer. Then the idea came that sharing. Yeah. If many people can work on this computer, why many people otherwise cannot work together? So the terminals went farther away with the technology coming in. So, okay, fine, this happened. Then luckily for us, something called internet came. When internet came, then the white people, our predecessors, they started, okay, there is something called some protocol, some system. If you can standardize them, those things can work around. So if TCP/IP came, all computers, all network equipment could work around. So then it became a concept of networking. Then we see more computers working with more computers, rather more machines working with more machines. Fine, that was also fine. That's not uncommon. I did not see any seminar at that time also. Seminar was on technology, seminar was on computer, seminar was on networking, seminar was on equipment. So, anyway, I still remained confused. Then we looked into, then mobile came. Along with mobile, what happened? With the mobile coming, we suddenly found that all things can be done in a remote manner, in a mobile manner. Mobile devices can communicate. Instead of fixed devices communicating, mobile devices could communicate. So that became another development. Fine. When this development happened, what next? So I looked at my organization, like Indian Railways. We found, okay, railways, we are running trains by methods, by communication, all these things were available. When we modernized, then we started communicating from even train to train to by some wireless means or some physical communication means on technology, some data getting transferred. So that is also not machine-to-machine communication. Then what is machine-to-machine communication? So anyway, put more stress on my mind. Then I realized that something has gone much beyond this normal human facilitators. These things are all facilitate our life, our common work. Something has gone much beyond that. That's why somebody is talking M2M today. So I was going through the website. I even talked to these people. So he said, what do I talk to? He said, you can talk on anything. That's fine. That's job of our speakers. You give us any topic, we'll start speaking. Then I realized that with the development of technology and the technology becoming so frequently disturbing the human aspect of life, so that people now want that, earlier I wanted technology to facilitate me, to communicate to somebody or to, like, as Bimal shared a lot of experiences, I don't want to get into that. I could do something, I could remotely control, switch on things and like all those things. It was like a facilitator, we are enjoying our life because technology was facilitating. Now it is becoming so complex, you don't have any time. Now you want why this technology should bother me. Now the technology should be taken care of. This machine should talk to only machine. I am talking on a, when these things are started touching common human being, now the topic became important. Otherwise, what is not machine-to-machine communication? My Mars mission is not machine-to-machine communication. My launch of satellite is not machine-to-machine communication. These things just cannot work. Human being does not do anything but for pressing the last button. 987600, it just goes, that's all. After that, everything is left to machine. So it is machine to machine. So when it is now likely to touch the common life of a man, these things become very important. Now, so that example is like, you look at now things in the new areas, like railways, we are trying a system that wherever is the train, it should be tracked automatically. People should know, they should be communicated, they should get a SMS. If you book a ticket, if your ticket is waiting list, if it gets confirmed, you should know automatically. In an inquiry, if you want to do something, just get into net, log in, find out where your train. It will tell you where the train. No need to ask an inquiry person, because that is irritating, because repetitive work given to any human being is irritating, and machines are very comfortable on that. So then I realized, okay, now this is M2M, that's why there is a forum, that's why there is a youngster who has thought of that this forum should bring in together. And I think, at least I am confused, I feel he is also confused, that which vertical of the government or the technology he should be working. I see the board of your ministries, right, who has Ministry of Road Transport, Ministry of Earth Sciences, Ministry of the Urban Development. Technologically, not telecom. I happen to be here just because NTCIL. We are the probably people closest to this thing who happen to be naturally, Mittal is there. So it is a totally new area. It is neither telecommunication nor IT. Because this could communicate with any machine, like it could be a machine in shop floor, it could be a machine in your house, it could be a machine anywhere. Now, houses, I was going to find some house in Noida, Greater Noida. Somebody said, we have made e-homes. I said, what is e? Like e-governance. So I thought maybe something new has come. He said, hey, everything will be done right from gate. You can control, you can from your mobile, you can switch on light, switch off light, run AC, whatever, n number of things that they do for of things. And I didn't understand why it is required, but one fine morning you will find that every house has all these things. Now, when these things start touching common human life, then it becomes very important. And that's why probably this is the topic. And probably we should touch into this aspect that, okay, we do technology, that's fine. Something is required naturally, like I said, launching of satellite, all those things. But when it is touching common life, to what level we should automate things? Because it should not happen that either we become too lazy or we become totally dedicated to machine, we do not know what happens. Like we are saying that, I saw a driverless train in Japan sometimes in 92. Well, I couldn't believe that because I was sitting on driver's seat. Driver was not there. I said, what do you do on this? You don't have people to drive. He said, no. Generally, people demand you put a driver also there. He just sits on the seat like you are sitting. So similarly, now they are talking of cars. Fine. It will be a driverless car. Like you have automation today on your map. You can go various places. But it should not happen that I don't want to even drive and car takes me anywhere. Giving direction is fine. Now there is a limit we should decide to what level these machines should affect our lives, affect our common life. It should not happen that something we just become a person who just operates the gadgets and don't do anything. I am already apprehensive with the so much abuse of technology by the younger generation. I don't know whether they will still have the R&D mindset. Because everything is available. They even don't know tables. They just use calculator for knowing what is 5:2. And to us, at least table till 20th was made totally, you must remember, 19 table, 17 table, 18 table. Not that it was something great which could not be done otherwise. So, I also tried to get some more information. There are standards have come up. There are ETSI standards for all M2M applications because ultimately when two devices communicate, the protocol has to be there, the system has to be there, the arrangements have to be there by which they will communicate. So the ETSI standards have been already issued for number of applications on that. And all those applications will facilitate development of this technology. Some of the opportunities are very useful for us. Like you can track your vehicle if it is lost. You can all those things are available with the GPRS, GPS, which Vimal has already covered in various areas. But my only submission to this forum is this is a very good beginning. I find it very interesting. That's the reason I came also here. And let us keep one factor in mind that whatever we do in technology, that how much is the interference or intervention in the normal human life, we should permit on that. With this note, I'd like to close. Thank you. Thank you for giving me.